If you've ever stared at a production issue thinking, where the hell is this request getting stuck? You're not alone. That's exactly why application performance monitoring exists. And in this video, I'll walk you through the core APM concepts in Datadog. What a trace is, how spans work, and which data actually gets stored, kept, or sampled. We'll break down the three layers of observability: real-time spans, retained traces, and long-term APM metrics. All with retention details and sampling strategies you actually need to understand before going into production. So whether you're new to APM or trying to avoid burning your ingestion budget, you're in the right place. Let's get into it. All right, before we get into retention periods or metrics, let's start with the foundation of APM: traces and spans. Think of a trace as a full request, like a user's journey through your backend, from the moment they click a button to the moment they get a response. Inside that journey, every individual operation, like a database call, an HTTP request, or a queue message, is a span. Traces are made of spans, and those spans are where Datadog collects all the juicy details: duration, errors, tags, and more. Think of it like a movie, maybe a detective story. The trace is the whole movie from start to finish. It shows every scene, every twist, every bottleneck along the way. Now, a span is like a single scene in that movie. It represents one operation, for example, an HTTP call to a downstream service, a database query, or a function execution. Here's an example. This trace shows a web request hitting an API, which first talked to an authentication service. Then it calls a database service, which itself calls the database. Each of these operations is a span, and together they form a trace that took about 600 milliseconds end-to-end. Each span has metadata: when it started, how long it took, what service or resource it touched, and whether it succeeded or errored. Together, all those spans, connected with parent-child relationships, form the full trace. That's how you can zoom out to see the big picture, or drill in to find a specific problem. So, if you're troubleshooting performance, a trace shows you where time is being spent and what component is responsible. It's especially powerful when services are distributed, because tracing connects the dots across every hop in your infrastructure. And that's why APM starts with this. Traces and spans are how you tell the story of every request in your system. In this example, we can see that 27% of the time is spent in service web store, but we can also see that this span from the whole trace was relatively slow compared to others. Let's start with a live demo. What is displayed here is a trace. It helps us to better understand the dependencies between the services and how an error at a lower level can propagate up to the front end. In this example, for instance, we can see that the store front end service made a request to the service call service proxy, which itself made a request to the store discount. And we can see at this level that there were multiple methods called within the framework. These last span for our service store discounts has made multiple requests to the database. I assume to check the validity of the discount for the current timestamp and for this user. Now that you know what a trace and a span are, let's answer the next big question. What telemetry does Datadog actually collect through APM? Because understanding what's being captured and how it's used is the key to getting real value out of tracing. Datadog APM captures three main layers of telemetry: spans and traces, APM metrics, and metrics derived from APM spans. Let's walk through each of these. Even though APM is known for the traces, APM in Datadog also includes metrics. Those metrics come out of the box with any app instrumentation, and they provide a significant value in addition to spans and traces. Those metrics are based on 100% of the traffic and stored for 15 months. This gives a good overview of what's happening now, but also trends across long periods of time. In parallel, traces are still collected to better understand the correlation and relationship between services. Every time an instrumented piece of code runs, like a database query or an HTTP request, it creates a span. Spans include start and end time, duration, a service name, operation name, resource, status, success or error, and any custom tags you add, like NV user underscore ID or customer underscore plan. These are the raw, high cardinality building blocks of everything APM can show you. When a request passes through multiple services or components, those individual spans get stitched together into a trace. Traces give you full visibility into the path a request takes, across services, containers, or even cloud providers. Here you can see how a single web request fans out with individual sub-requests to collect different information. The trace connects them all and shows you how long each took. Finally, Datadog derives metrics from these spans behind the scenes. For example, the number of hits, the number of errors and latency percentiles like P50, P95, P99. These metrics are aggregated by environment, service, resource, and optionally a secondary primary tag of your choice. And the best part, they're retained for 15 months and never sampled. So even if you decide to sample spans later to save on cost, your dashboards and monitors will still work off complete high-resolution metrics. It's a really smart balance between performance, data fidelity, and cost control. All right, now that you know what spans and traces capture, let's focus on something a lot of people overlook, APM metrics. These are your long-term high-level performance indicators, derived automatically from your spans, and they're crucial for dashboards, alerts, SLOs, and trend analysis. Let's first look at the Google SRE book in Chapter 6. The Google SRE book talks about the four golden signals. Those are latency, traffic, error, and saturation. You can read more later on, but the idea is APM relies on those four signals to evaluate the health of an application and identify symptoms of an underlying issue. This is what Datadog in the service page highlights them in the first section called Service Summary. We have here the number of requests per second that can be broken down by versions. We can visualize the error rate. Other related metrics for error are also available in the dropdown. Finally, the latency is also visible as well as other related metrics. The saturation that the Google SRE book is mentioning could be extracted from some of these depending on the system that is observed. Sometimes we may also refer to those golden signals, the red metrics. Red being R for throughput, E for error or error rate, and D for duration or latency. So where does those metrics originate from? As your services emit spans, the Datadog agent turns that raw span data into pre-aggregated metrics. Things like how many requests hit this service or endpoint, the total and average latency, how often things fail, and percentile-based latency, P50, P95, P99. These metrics are rolled up by environment, service, resource, version, and an optional secondary primary tag. And here's what makes this especially powerful. Unlike raw spans or traces, which might be sampled or dropped over time, APM metrics are retained for a full 15 months without sampling. That means you can look back over an entire year and a quarter, see performance trends, audit SLOs, and measure improvements without ever losing granularity. So even though spans are short-lived and traces might be sampled, your APM metrics are always there, accurate, fast, and ready to power dashboards and alerts that actually help you sleep at night. At this point, you might be wondering, what data actually gets stored in Datadog? What do I see live, and what do I still have access to tomorrow, or 2 weeks from now? That's what this section is all about, the difference between ingested spans and indexed spans. When your services emit spans, they're sent to the Datadog agent that can provide a first level of sampling. In most cases, if you are not a very large company, 100% of the spans should then be forwarded to Datadog. For the others, don't worry, we will cover such topic in another video. Once the spans reach Datadog, they are immediately ingested and used to power real-time features, like the live search view or the metrics from spans. These ingested spans are visible for 15 minutes by default. Think of them like a live fire hose, fast, up-to-date, but short-lived. This is super useful when you're debugging something that just happened, such as a live incident, or watching traffic patterns in real time. But if you want to analyze traces later, maybe correlate issues or build more persistent workflows, you'll need to store some of those traces. That brings us to indexed spans. These are spans retained for 15 days. Those spans are then indexed and fully searchable. Note that even though only the attributes of the span are searchable, the full trace will be visible when opening for details. And you can decide to keep spans of interest based on rules, tags, or business logic. Those indexed spans then power features like span monitors, dashboards, or trace analytics. But here's the important part. Not all traces are retained. That's where most of the sampling comes in. Datadog lets you configure sampling rules, either in the agent or through retention filters in the UI. you can choose to keep. All traces with errors, slow traces over a certain duration, traces from a specific endpoint or customer, or you can set a flat percentage, like retain 10% of all traces from this service. This gives you the best of both worlds, visibility into what matters, without storing every single trace and blowing through your budget. To sum it up, you get 15 minutes of real-time ingested spans for immediate debugging. You get 15 days of stored indexed spans and their associated traces for deep and longer-term analysis. And you're in full control over what gets retained. It's a system designed to scale without sacrificing visibility. Now that we've talked about what gets retained, let's dig into how you decide what's worth keeping. This is where sampling strategies come into play. And in Datadog, you get a lot of control here. If you're running a high-throughput service, you're probably generating millions of traces per day. Storing every single one would be overkill, not to mention expensive. But the good news is, you don't need every trace to get value. You just need the right ones. Datadog supports several layers of sampling. Head-based sampling, simple and scale well with cost. It is based on fixed rates per service and can be configured in the service instrumentation configuration. Example, keep 20% of traces from the payment service. Tail-based sampling based on trace content. It helps to make decisions after seeing the full trace and supports complex logic, like only keeping errors or specific endpoints. It is controlled via retention filters in the UI. For example, you could keep traces with http.status_code in the 500 range, traces with latency over 500 milliseconds, or all traces tagged with customer tier enterprise. Pro tip, you can also stack rules, keep all errors, and sample 5% of healthy requests. That way you get both coverage and cost control. This is super powerful because you can dial in exactly what's valuable to your team, errors, edge cases, premium users, or slow paths, without flooding your storage with noise. So when you think about sampling, remember, it's not about losing visibility. It's about storing what matters and skipping the noise. Datadog gives you the knobs. You just have to decide what matters to your team. Now that we've covered spans, traces, metrics, and sampling, let's talk about what all that data enables at a higher level. The service catalog in Datadog. The service catalog is kind of like a directory of every service reporting APM data. Here you get ownership, like the team or Slack channel responsible, links to dashboards, runbooks, and docs, SLOs, and dependencies. Key metadata like language, framework, and deployment frequency. So if you're trying to build a culture of ownership or align devs and ops around clear service boundaries, the catalog makes it real. And the best part? It's auto-populated based on your APM data and you just need to enrich it. The service catalog take you beyond individual traces and give you system-wide observability with context. All right, let's quickly recap what we've covered so far, because this was a lot of signal, and hopefully, not a lot of noise. A trace is the full journey of a request across your system. A span is one operation within that journey. Datadog collects spans, connects them into traces, and builds APM metrics for long-term visibility. Spans are ingested live for 15 minutes, and can be retained for 15 days. Sampling lets you store only the traces that matter most. APM powers the service map and catalog, giving you system-wide visibility and ownership out of the box. Whether you're debugging a latency spike, tracking errors in production, or trying to build a culture of service ownership, Datadog APM gives you the telemetry and the tools to do it right. And now that you understand the fundamentals, you're ready to go deeper. In the next video, I'll show you how to actually instrument a service with tracing, push data to Datadog, and start exploring traces in the UI. So hit subscribe, give this a like if it helped, and drop a comment if you have questions or want a walkthrough of a specific feature. And as always, happy monitoring!